Hey guys, this is Sushil.
Hi, JP here.
And we're the team behind a brand new travel and food blog by the name of Wander and Gobble. And for our first video today, what we have decided to do is a South Indian theme day. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be having South Indian meals from morning till evening. We're going to start off with two legendary breakfast joints by the name of Cafe Madras and Cafe Mysore. We're going to have lunch at a very little known joint, but an authentic Mangalorean cuisine restaurant by the name of Harish Lunch Home. And we're going to end our day with dinner with, again, a very less known restaurant, but with authentic Andhra cuisine by the name of Avakai.
So, as he mentioned, yes, it is going to be very good session right now on this camera. And what you're going to see on YouTube is, till the end, you'll love the food which we are showing. So I would suggest you that in future, if you want to see our videos, go and subscribe to our link and ensure that you also press the notification button so that you get the best and the unique cuisine experience on our YouTube channel. So here we go.
This is the first stop which we are having today is Cafe Mysore. One of the authentic one, and you can see it's mentioned there. It's one of the oldest which we have here in Bombay.
Yeah. And we're here for our first breakfast of the day. So come along with us. So what we're looking at here is idli gadbad. This is apparently a speciality dish of Cafe Mysore. What we can see here is idli covered in rasam with a lot of patsan. So that's the reason why it's idli gadbad.
This is heaven.
So what we're trying next is another speciality of Cafe Mysore. It's called rasam vada. So we have two vadas that have been dunked into their custom rasam. Ensure that your rava is properly hydrated. Good combination. There might be people who would think that, you know, the crunch of the vada is lost by dunking it in the rasam. But the rasam adds a lot of flavor into the vada as well. So, amazing combination as well. It's well known in this region, in this hotel. So, little doubt why as to why it's so popular. It's amazing. So the trickiest part of starting to consume this is to open up this nest of jackfruit leaves. And once you have the idli out of it, you have a proper steamed idli. Let's give it a go. While it is, while some may say that this is normal idli batter, the leaves do impart a little bit of flavor, so it does give it a unique taste. So really something special to try out when you're here at Cafe Mysore. Since my friend Jay could not finish this onion rava dosa, it is left to me to kind of tackle this. So rather than a normal rice batter, we're looking at a rava based or a semolina based batter out of which a rava is made out of. So let's see how it goes. People normally prefer in the rava dosa is the added crunch that it gives compared to a normal rice batter dosa. The spice in this dosa is also amazing. Gives added taste, gives added texture. All in all, a complete dish. So eat it while it's hot. That's our recommendation. You know, you might suffer a couple of mouth burns, but eat it while it's hot and crispy. That will be the best way to eat.
We spent over half an hour to 1 hour here, and the experience was different because it's a morning time. Four dishes we had: idli gadbad, rasam vada, we had onion rava dosa, and we had puttu. These are the four things which are quite common. People approach here and they eat these specially. Now, if I had to rate this, I'm not the best rate guy here, but Sushil can rate and tell you how it was.
Right. From our experience, hands down, the onion rava dosa made the stop here. It was crisp, it was fresh, it was spicy because of the cumin that they've used. Excellent dish out of all the four that we tried. Real thumbs up to the rasam vada also. We saw a lot of people ordering it. Not exactly our choice, but really good stuff. We have to add a special note for puttu, which is a very special dish. It's a dish that's made on special occasions. My mom actually makes it for Janmashtami. So that's a real special dish that we had. Topped it all with their Raja coffee. Real good. Have it with less sugar. Don't have it with the normal sugar. But real good stop at Cafe Mysore.
But my personal recommendation, and thanks for the approach here for the review, but two things which I like the most. One, the rava dosa. Mind-blowing rava dosa they have. And the rasam vada. Because the way they make it, it's too light. And you know, you can actually go and eat this one or two times if you're really hungry. And opt to go for these two. And yes, as Sushil mentioned, top it up with that king, which they called Maharaj coffee. The best one, because there is a standard which they apply. They keep the sugar quantity high. But if you do not mention it, then they'll give you that kind of sugar intake. But if you want to have less sugar, perfect. If you can go with this, fine enough. So let's look at the other restaurants which we want to do it today. Now we'll go to Cafe Madras and see how things are. Okay, the first dish which we are having is one of their specialty here, which is a opam podi. And the kind of masala which is put on top is their traditional one. This is how you eat it. So you put the gravy on it, the chutney on it, and then you take a bite. And it's nice, and the taste is quite good because the kind of spice which is used, the malgam masala which is used here, is quite different. And that's why I think people actually opt to come for this dish. Mmm, 10 out of 10 when it comes to quality.
So this is the order that's been advised to us, that after having the upma podi, we have to try out their rasam vada before moving on to anything else. So we're going to stick to that. Someone has recommended that to us, so we're going to stick to that. Right? So, as per custom, try out the rasam first. Tangy as always, good amount of spice, good hit of chili, but amazing. Let's try it with the vada now. Perfect balance. The vadas, even though they've dunked in the rasam, they'll not become soggy. They still maintain a good amount of crunch, but they're quite soft. Combined with the rasam masala, it's amazing. There's good amount of tanginess, there's good amount of sponginess from the vada. Amazing combination.
You know, when you have to order something, it comes in 2 to 3 minutes. That's the fastest time. And they don't compromise on the quality of food, which is the best part. Now, the earlier dish which we had was upma puri. This is something which you should believe in. This is idli puri. The only substitute here is the idli part. But the practice is the same. So next on the menu is a set dosa. They've custom made this dosa for us at our request because we are having so much. We didn't want to waste any food, so they've custom made the size of the dosa, so we really appreciate that. So this is a set dosa fried in ghee or made in ghee, and they've served it along with the traditional chutney and sambar, and they've also added their malga pudi to this. So we're gonna try it out with all three. The malga pudi is quite mild, but because malga pudi is, you know, a gram ground, it can make your mouth a little dry. But no matter what it is, the taste combination is quite good. Let's have it with the chutney again. The fourth dish which we are having here now is thuppa dosa. Now the name suggests, normally people know that it's made of either rice and dal combination. But here in Madras Cafe, you get it only with dal. And that's the speciality here, they do not mix rice with it. So you can actually feel that, you know, the whole force of ghee coming in your mouth. It's like 90% ghee and some part of it may be tasting like dal in it.
We had five dishes here at this stop. We started with upma podi, we had rasam vada, we had idli podi, we had a set dosa, and the piece of resistance or the cream of the cake was their thuppa dosa, which they topped with malga podi.
Now if you look at the total morning time, morning we had Mysore, now we had Madras. I mean, what a combination. But we ended up with a great note in morning, especially with Madras. The thuppa dosa is what we recommend to all of them. Best part about Madras, why people opt to come to Madras is just because of that reason. The dishes are made in such a way, it's quick, it's convenient, it has the best quality. It is as per your desire. You can tell them how you want to make it and they are right on it. If I had to compare both of them, both are unique in their own fashion. Their way of making food is totally different. But a person who is new to Bombay, or if it's a regular thing where, you know, they are traveling in morning and they have missed out on their breakfast, this is the best place to come and have your breakfast. If you are towards the other side, this is something where I will recommend. Come to Madras and have thuppa dosa here.
We have to point out something that the owners mentioned. One of the owners of Cafe Madras mentioned was that we have to promote, or we have to support these kind of restaurants. These are heritage restaurants almost. They've been around for so many years in Bombay. Most of Bombay is getting covered by franchisee restaurant or chain restaurants. While we're good to support those, we have to maintain a support for these old standing restaurants, these single standing restaurants. They're keeping our tradition, they're part of the culture and the fabric of Bombay. So we have to ensure our support so that they keep going strong.
Welcome back, and after driving from Matunga, which is like around 30 minutes from here, this is the fort area. And when you come to fort, the best part about fort is it's an official area and people who are working here can actually pump in and get to this place. Now what is so special about this place? It's a proper authentic Mangalorean restaurant called Harish Lunch Home, and if you're around, you don't have to miss this. Because the food out here, niche market, kind of niche, so you don't get any other variety of cuisines from India, but specifically Mangalorean dish. And that's what we're gonna do today. I and Sushil are gonna eat their main specialty item. And the best part is, people out here are quite different. The dish which we always wanted to have here, this is the surmai fry. If you look at the dish, it's one of the biggest portion in the surmai fish, which is your kingfish, and the fish is actually battered very well. The only part here is it's being fried, so normally people don't offer it, but this is something which you cannot miss in Bombay. So let's start with this one. So if you crisp from outside, soft inside, you actually get the taste of fish, which is so prominent here.
and it's not smell. So you can actually feel this is a fresh fish which has been made by them. And it's been done very good. Second dish which we have here, by looking at it, most of us may be guessing by now, it's called Bombay Dum. But in the regional language, it's Bombay Fry, and it's been battered in such a way that if you see it, it's quite soft. The way it is battered, it's ensured that this crisp part is not that crisp. And the inside part is quite different. So if you look at inside, it's made really well. And it's been served with tomatoes and lemon. You may want to have the same particular pattern of eating food. This is the curry, which is mind-blowing. The Mangalorean flavor, which normally you do not get. So when you say authentic food, this is the curry which I will prefer having it alone or maybe separately here. Personally recommend it. The coconut flavor is mind-blowing. You can actually feel it. That's the way it is made, it's been preserved well, and then it is cooked well. So that's up to the team here. They're making it well.
So this is shellfish or clams. Sippi, as they call it here in Mangalore. In Marathi, you call it tisreya. So this is prepared with a heavy coconut gravy. It's going to be spicy, I know that from experience. It's an extremely typical Mangalorean dish. It's prepared with a heavy coconut gravy or paste, and that is made into a thick consistency so that it sticks to the clams. It's supposed to be had with your hands. You just pick one up. You already have the gravy stuck to the clams. You could just loosen up the flesh with your fingers and just take it. Together, you get a hit of the clams, you get a hit of coconut, you get a hit of the gravy, all in one bite. You'll feel a chilly aftertaste, and that's gonna make each and every bite that more interesting. Heavily recommended, heavily recommended. You just have to get this every time that you come down here. Heavily recommended. So what we've ordered here is prawns heroes. Another traditional Mangalorean dish. So this is prawns that is cooked in a gravy that's heavy in ghee. It, you can see the curry leaves are visible. It's supposed to be mildly spiced, but the flavor of ghee will be overriding in this. To accompany this dish, what we have is something again very common in Mangalorean cuisine. This is neer dosa. This is a rice batter that is a slightly watery batter and that is fried into these kind of light dosas. They normally accompany a lot of Mangalorean dishes. And because we loved it so much, they were kind enough to give us another serving of their amazing, amazing fish curry. The first overwhelming taste that will hit you is the taste of ghee. The neer dosa accompanies it so well. But the taste of ghee is so overpowering. And then once you do swallow your bite, what you're gonna get is a aftertaste of spice. You're gonna get chili, you're gonna get black pepper, and it's just amazing. Again, the aftertaste you're gonna get is of curry leaves also. I wanna try this neer dosa with this amazing curry, and that's gonna be my next bite, so let's have it. This curry might be one of the best fish curries that I've had. So again, we've had it with fried fish, we've had it with neer dosa, and this has been just mind-blowing combination or accompaniment with everything. We're gonna indulge further.
The first one which we had was bombil fry and the surmai fry. Surmai fry was awesome, no doubt about it. It was made well, on mark, because it was soft inside. Same way bombil fry was done well. We came to know the way it was made. It's as per order, and they have already done their forecasting. They know how much the order will come every day, and that's how quickly they make it. It's so efficient in nature. People are actually putting in the effort to make it more quality type, which is the best part for Bombay fry.
Shellfish tukka.
Yeah.
And that was one amazing, so packed with flavor. It was something unforgettable. Right? It was spicy at the same time, authentic Mangalorean flavors, heavy coconut based gravy. But the best part was that the shellfish was so fresh.
Yeah.
One thing to mention here, and which we realized with speaking to Mr. Girish, who's the owner out here, was that they get their produce or they get their seafood from places like Bombay Docks. They get it from the place
the
where you
one.
Get the freshest seafood.
Yeah.
And that's why the output or the product is so amazing.
Right.
We ended with prawns, gyros, another authentic dish. We accompanied it with
Neer
Dosa. But I think for me, the best dish out of the stop here is the curry, of course, is the fish curry. But out of the four things that we had, I think the killer was the clam, the shellfish sukka was
nice.
Just amazing.
It gives just that flavor of, you know, you're having mussels if you're going out of India, but the way it was made with that coconut flavor, strong coconut, it really made our day, because that was something which I was not expecting from such a place which is less expensive, and it's a room where, you know, it's a permit room where people come from offices and their localities and eat food here. And that's what the owner also mentioned. People do not want to order food, but most of the time they come here, eat the food, they see their food in front of them, and that's how they love to eat such food out here.
Another thing is that we have to again support restaurants like these. These are promoting standalone cuisines, specializing in Mangalorean cuisine. These are dying out very fast, so we need to ensure that we support these kind of joints. This is a small joint, you might miss it if you blink, but this is there. We leave the links and the addresses of this place in our bio, but this is one place that you have to support. Serves authentic Mangalorean cuisine, right? We'll catch them soon again.
We've eaten here before, we know the place. As Jay said, you know, we're focusing on you know, a couple of places that might have authentic food, and this place does have authentic Andhra food, but it's not exactly so popular, it's not well known probably because of the location. So what we're trying to aim is to kind of bring that into the focus, give them some exposure, and hopefully you like what you see, you know, when we sample their food. So come along with us.
Okay. So at our final stop of the day, which is at Avakai, a Andhra themed restaurant, what we are having first is their Kodi Shorba, which is, in simpler terms, a chicken soup. But it's come in a deep red kind of soup, so it almost looks like a rasam, but we're gonna try it out now. It does have a deep spicy flavor, definitely chili in there, but you can feel the spice, right? You can feel the curry leaves in action here. You can definitely, there's enough quantities of chicken to make it a chicken shorba. But when we're talking about Andhra cuisine, you are talking about spice, and it is heavily spiced, but it's very flavorful. It's gonna wake you up once you taste it. I'm gonna have another go. That's right, that hit the spot. Thumbs up on that one. So the next dish on our appetizer list is their Meera Pakai Bhaji. I'm grateful that I got it all out in one breath. But what it is that it is a stuffed green chili that's coated in a light batter or a gram flour batter. And it's stuffed with onions, tomatoes, chilies, lime and chili powder. We've been told that the best way to eat it is to dunk it in their green chutney. And some people also prefer to eat it just like that. So I'm gonna try both ways, right? So here goes. Dunk it right in into the chutney. Try not to lose much of the filling. As you can see, it's a little messy. The stuffing is quite full, and surprisingly it's not spicy at all.
You would think that if you're eating a stuffed chili, it'd be spicy. Not spicy at all. There's a good hint of the onions and the tomatoes coming through it. There's a good hint of the lime that they've added onto it. So this is their Andhra version of Chicken 65. They've named it Chicken 65, but they swear by the fact that it is a traditional Andhra dish. We've been told that it's made with, it's a deep fried chicken dish. It's been made with onion, ginger, chilies and yogurt. So we're gonna try it out. We're gonna see whether it matches up to the Chicken 65 that we all know. The first thing that's gonna hit you when you eat this is the tartness. There is a tangy sour flavor that will hit you, and we've been told that that's a trademark of Andhra cuisine, between spicy and tanginess. And this dish was a perfect balance of that, where you saw a little bit of spice. It's lightly spicy, it's not at all spicy, but it was definitely tangy. The first taste that you get is tang in the back of your tongue, but the chicken is lightly fried, the chicken is fresh, and all in all a great meal.
So I don't want to end up on this, but this is something which I would recommend here. If you see the dish, it's actually steamed rice loaded with ghee on top of it. What we're gonna do is eat this traditional dish where steamed rice and ghee will be added with these masalas or pickles which you see here. So we're gonna start with the avakai pickle, which is their authentic one, and see how it tastes. So we'll go one by one and see how it tastes in different flavor. It's more typical pickled rice if you have, but a lot of oil in it. You can actually feel the oil and ghee mixture, which is not that common amongst different communities, maybe majorly in specific part of Mumbai. But this part, yes, it's good, but not that much.
You can't really go from here without tasting their paisan, which is this parappu paisan. This is this is a very unique paisan, I must say. It's made with lentils, and what they've used is moong dal. And what they're doing is that they've added it into milk. There's some jaggery, it's made in jaggery, and there's definitely a hint of coconut that I've tasted here. So I'm gonna try it again. You can definitely feel the cardamom. You can feel the coconut. It's very heavy in it. But very comforting dish, I should say. This is very warm and perfect way to say goodbye to our stay here at Avakai.
So, Sushil, I don't know about this place, but yes, this was different.
This was certainly different. Not many foods, not many joints that we know with authentic Andhra cuisine.
Yeah.
So this is one of the few that we've come across. Again, like we said earlier, not a joint that is well known. This is an up-and-coming joint. It's in a very different neighborhood in Kandivali, so that's why maybe not well known. But we want to get the word out there for joints True. Like this, which promote authentic flavor.
Yeah.
So out here we had a variety of the dishes that they kind of recommended. But the killer for us, the one that made it for us, was the Chicken 65. It redefined what Chicken 65 is for us.
Yeah.
All of us think that it's a Chinese dish. The name does make it seem like Chinese, it resonates with Chinese, but
it was made in a different way, more of Andhra flavor in
correct,
it.
Correct.
Very simple, using ginger, onion, lemon, and adding that spice which
and that tang that hits you the moment that you eat it. That's what makes that dish.
So you don't get that, the gassy type of feeling after eating Chinese food. That's what you can avoid here. But Chicken 65 was one.
But couple of dishes that I
wild card entry,
couple of dishes what I have to kind of mention here is the Kodi Shorba that we started with. Very different kind of a soup. We call it a soup, but very different kind of a soup.
You can actually feel the spice in it. You can actually count how many of them were there inside. And I, being that much into spice, he was the one who liked it.
If someone has a cold or a bad throat, they will definitely find it as an elixir. And the dish that we ended with, very unique kind of a paisan.
Again, we're not really too much of a sweet tooth.
Yeah.
But that was something that we had to kind of comment on.
I actually started eating like...
Correct. And we went through a lot of it, right? And made with moong dal, not really common when it comes to sweet. So true. Excellent way for us to end at Avakai, I should say. And with that, we also come to an end of this video on South Indian themed dishes.
So, yes, this is something which I always wanted to share, and thanks for that, Sushil, because South Indian is what I was missing in the whole day cuisine, and it started from morning till evening and the journey was quite good. But the best part is our objective was not to, you know, consume a day like this, because everyone will not have time to do it on a daily basis. But if you are opting for a morning lunch or in evening, you want to have dining with your friends or family, we selected few authentic places which are good for people to gather around and, you know, enjoy the meal, get that taste of South Indian food. Rather, you know, the ones which is more fusion type, you have a lot of categories of Punjabi, Chinese also included in those food. So you do not get the right flavor from the chef. So that was the whole intention, and I'm sure you will love more videos which we will be presenting in future. But for that, the best part is,
yes,
you need to like.
If you did like this video and you want to support us, our channel, what we are doing, what we are promoting, please click on the like button. Please subscribe to our channel. Please click on that bell icon that you see on the top so that you're notified about our upcoming videos. And please do leave some comments for us. If we want us to cover something specific in your city, please do leave us a comment, and we'd be happy to kind of come back to you on that. All right. So see you on the next video.
And thanks for being there with us till the end of the video. Yeah. That's quite, honored. And we will ensure that we make more authentic videos like this in future once again.
So we'll catch you next time.